Hello, everyone. Tim Williams here on WJZ.com with your latest update from WJZ Weather. Looking at a dry start to your Tuesday with temperatures as of this update, just in the 7 o'clock hour, below freezing in parts of the area. 29 degrees at BWI Marshall. West-southwest wind at 3 miles per hour. We've had a variable direction on the winds, but it is a dry start to the day. Colder air is setting up, though. You do see 29 in Cumberland and in Hagerstown, 28 in Westminster, 29 in Elkton, 19 degrees out in Oakland. 30s down on the eastern side of the bay. We have 34 in Easton and in Cambridge, 32 degrees down in Ocean City. Our winds are coming in primarily with a bit of a north and northwest flow, and that's going to set the stage for the storm coming through. It's going to lock cold air in place, and with that cold air in place, any moisture that moves in tomorrow is likely going to be all snow, although we could see some milder temperatures and a bit of a trace and some rain down on the lower eastern shore. Winter storm watch is in effect for the 95 corridor. We're talking from Philadelphia right on down through Baltimore and D.C. That's in blue. Winter storm warning in effect. Higher amounts expected north and west of the Beltway. So with that, we'll talk about some early projections for your snowfall. We talked about higher amounts north and west, 8 to 12 inches north of the Beltway. We're talking northeast Maryland, Bel Air included, a little higher as you start to head out the 70 stretch and into the panhandle of West Virginia, 12 to 18 inches there, and 4 to 6 inches as you get to Baltimore, lesser amounts toward D.C. As you get south, and the temperatures will be a little bit higher. So what we're looking at here, clear conditions on the satellite radar composite, just some high, thin clouds out there. The storm is now forming down near Texas, Oklahoma, New Mexico, and that general area. So we're starting to see it form. It's going to take a route down near the Gulf and come back up on the coast. It's not going to be greeting us early in the morning. What we'll see is it's starting to get closer. Noon here, our future cast now is stopped. We'll start to see the leading edge moving into the region. That'll start to move in from the south. And then we get into the day, the entire day. It's just going to take a while for it to move on through, overnight and into Thursday morning. It's not until Thursday morning around, say, 7 or 8 o'clock that we start to see it tapering off, and then it starts to clear up by the afternoon. But because it's going to take so long, the snow is just going to accumulate, which is why we have the higher amounts. So we're looking at drier conditions as soon as we get it past. By the afternoon, we could even see some sunshine on Thursday. But in the meantime, we're looking at mostly sunny conditions, seasonably chilly. 43 degrees is our high for today. 28 tonight, mostly cloudy, but chilly and dry. And then for tomorrow, 35 degrees with an overnight low of 27. Never gets really warm enough until really Thursday afternoon to start melting down anything. We'll be looking at some early snow flurries on Thursday, and then we'll see some breaks. Temperatures stay cold overnight, so we'll be watching for some freezing on the roads. And then 39 on Friday, 41 on Saturday. Partly sunny conditions for both days. Chance of showers on Sunday, and then we stay nice and mild on Monday, 46 degrees. That'll all help to melt down some of the snow. There's your latest update from WJZ Weather. We'll see you here again on WJZ at noon, and of course cut-ins throughout this morning. Have a great Tuesday. See you soon.